Now I am going to tell you how to combine the capacitors. So there are two types of combinations when you join large number of capacitors together. Number one is series combination and number two is parallel combination. So let's see what is the combination of capacitors. Combination of capacitors. So first one is series combination. How do you join capacitors in series? Keep first capacitor, second capacitor, third capacitor, join this positive negative plate. Each capacitor has having positive and negative plate. Capacitance of these capacitors are C1, C2, C3. Join negative to the positive, negative to the positive. So finally you are left with one positive and one negative that you can connect across a potential difference source. Suppose applied potential difference is V. Two important points you have to remember about combination of capacitors. Number one, in series combination, the charge stored by each capacitor will be same. The charge stored by each capacitor is same. But potential difference across each capacitor will be different. I mean to say potential difference across, this is V1, this is V2, this is V3. You know that potential difference is defined as amount of work done in order to move a test charge from one point to another point. So and electrostatic potential energy is also defined as work done, but electrostatic potential energy is conservative in nature. It always depends on only initial and final position. So if somebody asks you the question why potential differences are different in series combination, however charges stored by each capacitor remain same, answer is because here we take potential difference across different capacitors, so the points of measurements are different and the potential difference depends only on initial and final position, right? And since initial final position is changing, so this will be different. So first I said charge stored by each capacitor is same and equal to total charge stored by the system. Second point will be potential difference across each capacitor is different, but the sum of the potential difference is equal to total applied potential difference. So use relation. Using relation, V is equal to Q over C. You can write Q over C equivalent is equal to Q over C1, Q over C2 plus Q over C3. Q cancels. So 1 over C equivalent is equal to 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 plus 1 over C3. You can calculate equivalent capacitance in series combination. Now this is similar to a result which you have obtained in case of the parallel combination, right? In parallel combination of resistors. So now look at parallel combination. In parallel combination, the first important characteristics and points of combination will differ. How do you combine capacitors in parallel. Here positive is joined with positive, negative is joined with negative. These are two initial and final points across which you have applied your potential difference. V, C1, C2, C3, positive is with positive, negative is with negative. Fine. So here potential difference will remain same because initial and final position for all capacitor is same. So how do you make two important property of the parallel combination? Potential difference across each capacitor is same, but the charge stored by across each charge stored by each capacitor is different, but the sum of the charges stored is equal to total charge stored by the system. So this you can write C equivalent into V, C1V, C2V plus C3V. So VV cancels. What is left? C equivalent is equal to C2 plus C3. What do we mean by C equivalent? C equivalent means that if you want to connect some value of capacitor in the circuit, and if you don't have that value of capacitor with you, then you can take at least three different or two different values of the capacitors, and when sum can be made equal to this, connect these two capacitors in parallel, the sum will be equal to the required capacitor. So you can work it out practically even with the help of two capacitors. Let's do one or two quick numerical problems. Just have a look for this numerical problem. Simple one. This is one fork. This is another fork. This is given positive charge, this is given negative charge. Separation distance is D. What is equivalent capacitance? Find equivalent capacitance. Before calculating equivalent capacitance, you must see that what is the combination. This arm will be carrying positive charge, this is positive charge, this is negative charge, this is negative charge. One positive and one negative capacitor 1. One positive and one negative capacitor 2. One positive and one negative capacitor 3. Now see the combination. Negative plate is common in between 1 and 2. It means negative is connected to the negative, so it is parallel. This is positive pump is common in between 2 and 3. So positive is connected to the positive, so these are parallel. It means all these three capacitors are in parallel combination. Since all these are in parallel combination, so equivalent capacitance you can easily find C1 plus C2 plus C3, that is epsilon naught A over D, 3 times of this, that is C equivalent. Let's do these two more examples. Find equivalent capacitance between A and B. We can number these capacitors, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and C6. Now you see C2, C3, C4 are in series. C2, C5, C6 are in series. So equivalent capacitance, I am first counting this, that is 1 over C dash is equal to 1 over C2 plus 1 over C3 plus 1 over C4. So when you put the value of 1 over 2, 4 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4, right? What is LCM? 4. So it is 1 plus 2 plus 1 by 4. So C dash is equal to 341 microfarad. Is that fine? Similarly, now you take C5 and C6 in series, that 2 and 4 capacitors, these two. That is C1 over C double dash, you can say, is equal to 1 over C5 plus 1 over C6 is equal to 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4. That comes out to be 3 by 4. So it means C double dash is equal to 4 by 3 microfarad. Now this arm is in parallel to this, therefore C equivalent 1 is equal to C single dash C double dash, that is 1 plus 4 by 3, that comes out 7 by 3 microfarad. So this whole structure is reduced to now equivalent to A 4 microfarad, and this is another is 7 by 3 microfarad, and you are reaching at point B now. Now you see 4 and 7 are in series, sorry, pair series. So net equivalent C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C equivalent 1. Right? No, series. So 1 over C1 plus 1 over C1, 1 C equivalent series. So that comes out to be 1 plus 3 by 7. Yes or no? Not 1, it is 1 by 4 plus 3 by 7. So 3 by 7, LCM is 28, that is 7 plus 12, that is 19 by 28. So you can easily find C equivalent is how much now? C equivalent is equal to 28 by 19 microfarad. That's how you can calculate equivalent capacitance. Check it out, many problems, as many as you can. Now another problem, find the ratio of potential difference that must be applied between two parallel and series combination of the capacitors with their capacitance ratio. Solution, what is given? C1 over C2 is equal to 1 by 2 is given. This is given. Now in series, your equivalent capacitance will be C1 C2 plus C1 C2. From here you can get C2 is equal to 2 C1, equation number 1. Equation number 2, for parallel you can solve it more, C1 plus C2. When you put the value of this, then C1, 2C1, 2C1. So your answer is 2 by 3. Right? 2 by 3 C1, because 1 C survives. Now Here when you put it, then you will get 3C1. Equation 3. What is condition? Potential energy stored in series combination V series whole square is equal to in parallel combination Vp whole square. This is same. So this cancels. Cs is how much? 2 by 3C1 Vs square. Cp is how much? 3C1 Vp square. C1 cancels. So what is left? Vp over Vs square is equal to 2 by 9, that is Vp over Vs is equal to root 2 over 3. Is the answer clear? Now we will discuss one more type of the question which is slightly different than these questions based on Wheatstone bridge, and Wheatstone bridge will be taught to you next chapter. Suppose questions are this is the combination of capacitor. A and B. Here you have connected potential difference C1 over C2, C3, C4, C5. Now you have to be careful about these questions whenever it is asked in the examination. Look at whether circuit is carrying 5 capacitors or not. It might be a question of Wheatstone bridge, balanced Wheatstone bridge. What is balanced Wheatstone bridge? Always find when there are 5 capacitors, check it whether the ratio of any 2 capacitors is equal to other 2 capacitors, other side capacitors. It can be like this also, C1, C3 is, or you can check like this, C1 is 2, C3 is equal to C2 over C4. If this is there, if this condition is justified, then it is balanced Wheatstone bridge condition. If question is of balanced Wheatstone bridge, then this bridge arm capacitance becomes immaterial. So you can remove this capacitance. And then how many are left? 4. C1 and C2 are in series. C3, C are in series. C4 are in series. Find equivalent capacitance of these two, then these two, and then parallel combination. But if this condition does not hold good, does not hold, then what? Then it's still easy. C1 and C2 are in series, C3 and C are in series, then you can have 3 parallel arms. C dash is equivalent of C1, C2. C5 is intact. And C double dash is equivalent of C4, C3 and C4. So finally you will have 3 capacitors. And they are in parallel. So find equivalent capacitance. Let us see now what is common potential. Common potential is also a similar concept as in case of the heat energy, when you have two bodies A and B. One is at higher temperature, another is at lower temperature, and you bring these two bodies in contact, then temperature of higher body gradually falls and temperature of lower temperature body gradually increases until both bodies reach on some intermediate temperature. Once this equilibrium is attained, there is no flow of heat energy. Similar conditions here, when you join capacitors, they finally reach on common potential. So what is common potential? Just have a look. Common potential. VC I have given symbol. Consider two capacitors. Capacitor C1, which is charged by a potential difference V1 separately. And another capacitor of capacitance C2, this is charged by a potential V2. Both the capacitors are charged separately by different potentials. So obviously they will acquire different kind of different potential energy. This will have C half C1 V1 square, this will have half C2 V2 square. After charging these two capacitors, I mean charged capacitors, C1 and C2 are joined in parallel. Now what will happen? The charge begins to flow from higher level to lower level until both the capacitors reach on common potential, and this common potential is Vc. So how do you calculate common potential? Common potential formula is total charge of a system divided by total capacitance. Total charge is how much? C1 V1, C2 V2. Capacitance is how much? C1 plus C2. So this is C common potential, sorry. Now suppose you have formed this system and it has achieved common potential. So in which case energy stored is more? If we sum up the energy of these individual and then take a difference with the system formed by combining two capacitors in parallel, what we observe, we find there is a loss of energy. So the next article is loss of energy in a system. How do we find loss in energy? Initial potential energy. पहले वाले का क्या हो गया? Half C1 V1 square. For second is half C2 V2 square. Then total initial energy. Initial electrostatic potential energy, how much it is? U initial is equal to U1 plus U2, that is half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square, right? Final kinetic energy is how much? UF is equal to half C equivalent BC square, that is half C1 V1. C equivalent is how much? Parallel combination, so you can say C1 plus C2. BC is there, that is C1 V1 C2 V2 over C1 plus C2 whole square. Right, this is final. Then if you want to see whether there is a loss in energy or gain in energy, I don't know, what you find? You find change in energy, and that will let you know. So if I say change in energy is UI minus UF, if initial energy is more than final energy, then loss in energy or change in energy will, delta U will be positive. If final energy is more than initial energy, then obviously delta U will be negative. So solve that, you will have half C1 V1 square, half C2 V2 square minus half 1 C1 plus C2, as C1 plus C2 will cancel. So what is left? C1 V1 plus C2 V2 whole square divided by C1 C2. Solve this, you will get answer. It looks little longer, but have patience and you can do that. C2 V2 square. Let's start straight away multiplying with this. So first term C1 here, C1 square V1 square. Then C1 with the second term, C1 C2 V2 square. Then C2 is C1 C2 V1 square. Then with this, C2 square V2 square. Then minus square of this, C1 square V1 square, C2 square V2 square, minus 2 C1 C2 V1 V2. Check now. If you find anything can be cancelled, cancel it out. Anything which cannot be removed, that will be there. C1 square V1 square cancels. C2 square V2 square cancels. And in the rest of terms, if you see C1, C2 are common. So you have half C1, C2 over C1 plus C2, because it is LCM is continuing. What is left in the bracket? V1 square plus V2 square minus 2V1 V2. So your answer is delta U is equal to C1 C2 over C1 plus C2. That comes out V1 minus V2 whole square. Now this quantity can never be negative. Why? Because even if V2 is greater than V1, you are obtaining term there as positive term, because square comes. So this will be positive. Let's take an example for this. A 4 microfarad capacitor is charged with 200 volt supply. Fine? And then disconnected to supplier. Connected to another. Disconnected from supply and connected to 2 microfarad capacitor. Find common potential and loss in energy. So solution is very simple. Common potential Vc is equal to C1 V1 plus C2 V2 over C1 plus C2. Put up the value, you will get what? 4 into 200 volt micro coulomb by 4 plus 6 microfarad. That is, you will get what? 3. You will get 100 by 400 by 3. Volt. Right? Micro gets cancelled. Then change in energy. Half C1 C2, that is 4 into 2 into 10 raised to power minus 12, 6 into 10 raised to the power minus 6, V1 minus V2, V1 is 200, minus 400 by 3 whole square, that is 8 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 by 6 into 600 minus 4, 200 by 3 whole square. When you solve, your answer will be 2.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 joules.